Yes, we had the first look is a quasi-random number sequence. So we were in the chapter of random number generation. We started looking at low discrepancy sequences. And our first sequence was the van der Koppel sequence. And now I like to do another computer experiment with you. And that computer experience goes back to, well, a session that we had really a while ago. Let me check if I can find it. And that was here. Yeah. So we had a session. if we like to generate a vector of random variables or vector valued random variables or a random vector, then we can do the following. We take a one dimensional sequence and we just populate every entry of the vector. You know? And then if the vector is completed, we have generated one element of the vector valued sequence. So maybe you remember that. And we already had also some experiments. We were doing this in two dimensions and we got these nice plots. Yeah. So this is now a vector of a two-dimensional random point, yeah, using a one-dimensional Mersenne-Twister sequence. So now we learned that we have a new type of sequences, the low discrepancy sequences. And maybe I just like to do the following experiment. So I take, I generate a two-dimensional random vector from a one-dimensional pseudo-random number generator and from a one-dimensional van der Koppel sequence, and we check what happens. Okay, so let's do that. So now it becomes handy that we already generated these interfaces here. So we have the interface for the random vector, and we have the interface of a random sequence in one dimension, which is actually a special case of this random vector. And we already started implementing a random number generator that implements this, namely a quasi-random number generator, the van der Koppel sequence. So now I have this random number generator, and we can generate maybe a plot using this generator. Let me go back. So the exercise here is I would like to generate a two-dimensional sequence from a one-dimensional one. Maybe that could be a general class that performs this. Let's implement such a class that performs this for any kind of generator. Let's call this random number generator from one dimensional generator. So this implements a random number generator in any dimension from a given random number generator in one dimension. So it should implement here the next value and the dimension. So of course, dimension is now a property. So I have here a property. Okay, and I need a one-dimensional generator that is used to generate the vector in the higher dimension. So I'm now implementing the stuff that we had in this session on how to generate a vector from a one-dimensional sequence. So I need here another ingredient, and this is now our one-dimensional generator. Which is given. So these two arguments are given, so I need a constructor for that. Okay, and then I can implement the method. Well, the dimension is of course just here the parameter dimension. And we have to return here a vector. So the new value. So this is now a vector of size dimension. Okay, then we populate this vector as it was written in the script with the values from the one-dimensional generator. So I ask the random number generator get next double. So I'm just populating this one by the other, and then I'm returning this vector. Okay, so now I have a nice method to generate a vector valued object out of a one-dimensional sequence. And I like to use this now with the Mersenne twister and the van der Korput sequence. So let's do a small experiment. So this is now random number generator 2D experiment. Okay. So it should have a main method so we can run it. And let's generate different two-dimensional random number generators. So it is random number generator, so a two-dimensional one. Using the pseudo random number generator, so it should generate a random number generator. So from 1D, and we now use here the Mersenne twister. To generate a two-dimensional sequence. Okay, so there is, what is the error here? I used the wrong Mersenne twister. That is maybe the wrong one. Oh, I don't have an implementation of the Mersenne twister. So I added here a Mersenne twister implementation. Okay, I need to add this. Yeah, so a Mersenne twister implementation implementing my interface. Yeah, so I have others. Okay, I have to complete here this implementation of a Mersenne twister. Well, I have different Mersenne twister implementations in the library, but maybe here it's nicer to use. Well, it was also here on the script to use just the classical Java random number generator. So I use here just a linear concurrential generator. Okay, maybe I just use that because that's then more consistent. Yeah, so. So I just use here the Java implementations and I just use the Java random number generator random. So I have a constructor. So that guy here is Java util random. Well, but instead of just specifying random here, I just specify the seed here and I have here new random with this seed. Okay, and then I can here just return the value. Okay, so now I have a pseudo random number generator that implements my interface. And we have the van der Korput sequence here that also implements my interface. Okay, so I can continue here with my small little experiment. Here I have to specify a seed. The other one is random number generator quasi. So that's now also a random number generator from 1D using our van der Korput sequence. I use a van der Korput sequence with base 2, or we can also use base 3, it doesn't matter. And we use it to generate a two-dimensional vector. So now I have two random number generators and I can create a nice plot similar to the plot we had in the script, plot sample points using this random number generator pseudo. So let's implement a small plot helper function. So I create the list of sample points. So the sample points is each sample point is a small two vector. So I have a list of the sample points. So then I fill this list. So let's take, say, 1,000 elements. Whoops. So let's import here the list. Let's call this points, yeah, in plural, because it is a collection. And I add generator. So that is here a general generator, doesn't need to be the pseudo one. So generator get next, which will give me immediately the vector, okay? Because that's now here a general generator that generates vectors. Okay, so that code is now very easy. Yeah? So maybe I can add a small title. So this is just the name of the generator. Okay, so I can distinguish the title and I create now a small scatter plot, a scatter of these points, well, from 0 to 1, from 0 to 1, with a certain dot size. And let's have also our title here and show this plot. Okay, so now he likes to throw an exception here and he likes to throw an exception here. That's okay. Let's run this experiment now. So where is my experiment? Okay, so that's now the output. Yeah, we see with the pseudo random number generator, the generated sample points. And we see here, again, areas where we do not have many points. Here we have areas where there are many points. Well, the title is not so nice because here my title is generated with the toString method. Maybe you should choose here a toString. That prints out here just the name of the class and also do the same here for the van der Koppel sequence. So we have nicer titles. And let's also plot now what we get if we use the van der Koppel sequence. Still, the title is ugly. Let me fix that. So I also need to, and I also need to add here a toString in the random number generator from 1D. So he prints the used random number generator. Okay, so now I can run my experiment here and the title will show the used random number generator. And we also print now the van der Koppel sequence. Okay, and you see, I use here my random number generator from one dimensional using the pseudo random number generator. And here using the van der Koppel sequence, okay, van der Koppel sequence with base 2. And you see that actually this is not random. So we have a problem. We cannot use the one-dimensional sequence, the one-dimensional quasi-random number generator in two dimensions. So this is of course clear, yeah, because the sequence has a very high structure. If you populate the vector one 2, and then the next one, 1, 2, and the next one, 1, 2, you have that if you start here with 1, the odd elements is always on the top, the even element is always on the bottom. Yeah, and you see that there is here, for example, some structure. This guy here is always larger than that guy here, right? It's because I'm always alternating here with the 1/2, and I'm always adding 1/2 and not adding 1/2. So I'm always in the same region. Yeah, if I now generate a two-dimensional vector from this sequence. So to solve this, we need to specifically define a low discrepancy sequence in higher dimensions. And that's what makes the research on low discrepancy sequence more difficult, yeah, because you really need to define the sequence in higher dimensions. So there is a sequence that is similar to this in higher dimensions. It's the Halton sequence. So the Halton sequences uses a van der Korput sequence for every component. So we have a van der Korput sequence with a given base Bj, and this van der Korput sequence defines the jth component of my vector valued sequence. And there's just one property we need. The basis for the individual components, they do not have greatest common divisor. So the greatest common divisor is of these guys here is 1. So for example, we can use prime number. Yeah? We can use 2 and 3. So let me complete now this session by implementing a Halton sequence. Yeah? And we then will plot the plot in two dimensions using the Halton sequence. So I do here new class. That should go quickly. Yeah, Halton sequence. So the Halton sequence is a random number generator in higher dimensions. So what do we need? We need a vector of bases. Okay, and the length of the vector will also define the dimension. Yeah? So basis.length is just the dimension. Of course, I need a constructor for that. So that's easy to generate constructor using fields. So that's just the basis which we define. And then the vector, the next vector is given by the specific van der Korput sequence with the corresponding base. So I also need here some running index. So integer current index. So initialize this to 0. So make it private. That one could also be final, so you don't modify it. So and let's now create the vector. So the vector of length dimension. Let's populate the vector. So I populate the vector value I is the van der Korput sequence number. So I can use here my van der Korput sequence, get van der Korput number with my current index using base. And now I use base I. So basis I, okay. And after that, I increment the index. And I return this vector. So now I have a sequence that has different van der Korput sequences with here two different bases. Okay, so should be right. I can turn back to my experiment and add here another quasi-random number generator. So that here will be quasi 1 and that here will be quasi 2. And now I use the Halton sequence. So this is new Halton sequence. I do not need to specify here the dimension, and I do not need to specify here this utility, because this guy is immediately in two dimensions if I specify a two-dimensional vector of bases. So this has now new integer here as an argument, and I use base 2 and say base 3. And let's also print this guy. And run the experiment. Okay, so now we have these results here. So upper left, whoops, is my pseudo-random number generator. You see I have clustering and empty spaces. This here is my wrong usage of a quasi-random number generator in two dimensions. Yeah. You see that I have here a structure. Yeah, I'm always below here this line. Yeah, so I'm always above here. And this here is now my Horton sequence, which is a combination of a base 2, so 1/2, 1 over 4, 1/2 plus 1 over 4, and a base 3, so that's 1 over 3, 2 over 3, yeah? And then it's the next one is 1 over 9, 1 over 9 plus 1 over 3, and so on. Yeah? So this here is a combination of a base 2 sequence and a base 3 sequence for the first and the second component. You see that there are sometimes structures, yeah, like lines, yeah. So there is some structure, but it looks very uniform. Yeah? It looks even more uniform than what we get from the pseudo-random number generator. And maybe we can use this class, the Holton sequence, to do some higher dimensional integration experiment in one of the next sessions. So you also find these plots in the script. To complete the session, let's go through the last slides here. So for the Holton sequence, you can also prove a nice convergence result. First here in the script is again the code, how you calculate the van der Korput number, or then also called Holton number. And you can prove that we have here for the Holton sequence, the estimate that it is, well, van der Korput was log n divided by n. This guy here is log n to the power of d divided by n. So that's still better than Monte Carlo. Yeah? It's not as good as 1 divided by n, but it's still better than 1 divided by square root of n. A small remark here. Of course, this guy here also grows with the n. Yeah? So if n is, for example, 10 million, yeah, then we can calculate the log n. So what is the log n? So that's something like 16. Okay, and then you can ask yourself, when is 16 to the power of d divided by n smaller or larger 1 divided by square root of n? Okay, and that gives you maybe a rough idea when, say, the Monte Carlo method, yeah, is 1 divided by square root of n is better or worse than that. Oh, of course, you don't know here the constant. So here's small exercise. Just a reference, there is research on low discrepancy sequences. You can also have a look at Sobol numbers, yeah, which are even a bit better. And we will have an experiment on how we can use these sequences to parallelize, so to make Monte Carlo integration faster in one of our next sessions. So that was it. Here you find the summary of the coding session. So that was our first exercise, the coding session done in the previous part. And that was the one which we just did, the two-dimensional from one-dimensional sequence exercise. And here you also have in the script the plots. So that's the two-dimensional plot from a pseudo-random number generator from a van der Korput sequence, yeah, which is wrong. Yeah, you have to be careful. And the Horton sequence. So you can find the code again in the repository of the lecture. And that was it for today.